Welcome to this overview of the types of charts available in eazyBI. In the previous video, we learned how to customize the timeline chart in order to produce the final report. In addition to the timeline chart, eazyBI has several other chart types to explore, and we will do just that. From the Analyze tab, let's open the report that we created in an earlier video and modify it. To simplify the report, select only one measure. Issues resolved. And change the grouping by the measures, not issue types. With this one report, we will be able to demonstrate most of the chart types simply by switching between the tabs in the report builder. Let's have a look. The bar chart is very popular. This chart can be used to compare different values from the same category. Use stacked bar charts to show composition. Be careful about using too many composition items. 3 to 4 are enough, otherwise it can get messy very quickly. We will save a copy of this report using a different name, so it can be easily found later. For stacked values, you can choose to display them either in absolute values or see a relative data comparison by selecting percentage. Data labels also can be added to see the values in the report. By the way, you can change the font size between small, medium, and large. Alternatively, all this data can be displayed in a vertical bar chart, simply by selecting vertical in the options. Line charts also are among the most frequently used chart types. Use lines when you have a continuous data set. These are best suited for trend-based visualizations of data over a period of time or iterations like sprints or releases. It is possible to change symbols for lines or to remove them entirely. An area chart is the same as a line chart with the area filled up below the line. Areas are typically stacked. The best use for this type of chart is for presenting cumulative value changes over time or iterations. Similar to the stacked bar chart, values on a stacked area chart can be displayed either in absolute values or as a relative data comparison by selecting percentage. A pie chart typically represents numbers in percentage and is used to visualize a part of a whole relationship or a composition. In this report, we are using the time dimension, and so the pie charts make more sense if the axes are swapped, making each pie to represent 1 month. Be careful not to bake too many pies, as it would be hard to consume them all. Select relative size to proportionally display all compositions based on value. A donut chart is essentially a pie chart, except it has a round hole in the center which makes it look like a donut. For better visibility for this chart, we can switch to the year level in the time dimension instead of month. Think of a donut chart as being a stacked bar graph that has been curled around on itself. We have several other charts too: map chart, gauge chart, Gantt, and scatter. We are going to explore them in later videos since they require a slightly specific report structure. Feel free to try them out by yourself though. In this video, we have covered options of most typical chart types: line, bar, and pie charts. In the next video, we will learn how to share created reports and charts with other users using eazyBI dashboards as well as Jira dashboards.